Hey, what's up, guys? This is FD Chick. Excuse my voice because it is pretty damn late at night and I'm doing this commentary out of nowhere. So I thought I would do another douche dates video for you guys, just because the last one that I did, if you haven't seen it already, and I'm gonna put the link down below so you can watch it if you would like, but it was pretty funny and a lot of you guys really liked it, got some really good responses. So I thought, why not do another one, since a few of you guys asked, and I have been on plenty of douche dates. So if you don't know what a douche date is, it's just pretty much me telling you guys about some dates that I've been on that either the guy was like acting really stupid or douchey or did something or, you know, said something, and I'm just like, what? Did you just do that? I don't know. So that you guys learn from my experiences and what not to do on your dates. So firstly, these are things that I think are pretty douchey, and in general, they really are. So let's see. Before I do that though, I just want to talk about the gameplay a little bit. This is a hard hat Moab that I got, and I was just kind of, you know, this is probably one of my favorite Moabs that I've had so far, just because when I was playing this, I was actually on Skype, so I didn't have any game sound on, and I was just kind of running around la-di-da, you know, and I was just like, oh, I got a Moab. So that was pretty cool. So to start off with my first douche date, I just want to say that I don't remember how I met this guy. He's probably just like a friend of a friend of a friend. This was a while ago. And he was like, hey, I know this really nice restaurant. Do you want to go out and eat? And it's by my place. And I was like, okay, cool. So he picked me up. He's from out of town. And we went to the restaurant. Everything was fun. You know, it was fine. We had dinner. And then we didn't really plan anything afterwards. So he said, do you want to go driving around? And I was like, okay. And he showed me a couple of his favorite spots. He showed me, like, where he went to high school and where he played basketball and all of that. So, and it was fine. And then, you know, we drove a little bit longer, probably about a minute or two. We came into this really nice neighborhood. I mean, it was like Beverly Hills neighborhood, if you can picture that. It was, you know, where all the movie stars live and football players live. And it was a really nice neighborhood with like million-dollar houses. And I was like, what is he like trying to show me? Like, is this where he lives? Or is he trying to tell me, like, this is what kind of house he wants? Or I don't know. So I asked him, I was like, what are we doing here? And he was like, oh, just wait a minute, I'll show you. I was like, okay. And then we drive maybe like a minute or two more, and we come to this little cul-de-sac. We stopped, and he pointed to the house to the left, and it was a really nice house. I mean, like I said, multi-million house probably. And he was like, see that house right there? I was like, yeah. He was like, yeah, that's where my ex-girlfriend lives. And I was like, what? I was like, we drove all this way for you to show me where your ex-girlfriend lived and how nice of a house it was. And I was just like, really? I mean, does this guy like have no common sense? I mean, I don't know if maybe I was overthinking it or something like that, but I thought that was really douchey, because imagine if it was our first date and I did the same thing. You know, I drove him to my ex-boyfriend's house, which just so happened to be like this million-dollar house, and was like, yeah, that's where he used to live. What do you have? You know, pretty much that's what he was saying to me, was, what do you have? And I was just like, oh my goodness. And I was thinking to myself, you know, if I knew we were going to do show and tell, I would have brought along my ex-boyfriend's boxer shorts just to show you. And no, I wouldn't have done that, but you get the idea. It's just not something that you want to do. So anyway, that was the first douche date. And yeah, I didn't see him after that again. Moving on to the next story. I wouldn't say this is a date just because we never actually went out on a date, but anyway, so I was in the mall, and I met this guy who's pretty cute. We had a good conversation, so I gave him my number, and a couple of days later, he gave me a call. But it was really late at night. It was like midnight or something when he called me, but I picked up the phone. We had a good conversation for like an hour or two, and then he was like, yeah, I'll call you back some other time. I was like, all right. So a couple of days later, he called me again, and it was also really late at night. I was like, man, this guy. But he was like, yeah, I'm sorry, you know, I'm calling you so late. It's just because I have to work and all that. I was like, oh, okay, well, that's cool. And this continued on for like a good maybe like week and a half. And then one morning, it was probably 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, really, really early in the morning. I was sleeping and I got a call from him and I was like, man, it is super early for this guy to be calling. And then I picked up the phone. I was like, hello. And then instead of his voice, I heard a girl's voice. And she was like, yeah, I found this number in my boyfriend's jacket and I just wanted to call and see who it was. And I was like, oh my goodness. No wonder he had called me so late. It was because he was hanging out with his girlfriend in the daytime. And then he would get home and call me at night before he went to sleep. And I was like, wow, are you serious? I wasn't even mad at her. In those kind of situations, you should never get mad at her. Because technically she hasn't done anything wrong to you. But I was like, yeah, this is so-and-so. And I gave my number to so-and-so at the mall. And she and I had a good conversation for about half an hour or so. I spilled the beans. I was like, he called me on this day and this day. And we talked about this and we talked about that. And he never mentioned you and blah, blah, blah. Or I never would have talked to him. And, you know, I was pretty pissed off that this guy had lied to me. And she had called me so early in the morning just to say that. And so, yeah, I gave her all the details and I told her exactly what happened. And then it was really funny because maybe after 4 days, he called me. I don't know if he knew. I don't know if she even told him, but he called me and I was like, why are you calling me? I gave him so much attitude. I was like, why are you calling me? And he was really, really confused. And he was like, what do you mean? And I was just like, yeah, don't call me again because, you know, I don't appreciate the fact that you lied to me. And your girlfriend did call me and we talked for a good while. And after I said that, he didn't say anything at all because he was just caught. He was like, okay. And then we hung up the phone and I never ever heard from him again, which was a good thing. So, life lesson here, don't give your number to a guy you met at the mall. No, I'm just kidding. No, just that, you know, keep that in mind. If that somebody is only calling you at night, it's probably just a booty call or something like that. So I think that's it for now. I got my Moab here and I was pretty damn happy. So anyway, if you guys enjoyed this video, let me know in the comments or rate it or, you know, whatever you guys feel like. And I do have a couple more douche dates I could tell you guys. So let me know if you want to hear those as well. Remember, guys, don't be a douche.